Mr. Speaker, I welcome the statement today and I publicly thank the Commission for its excellent work over many years. Having also visited several sites, could I please ask the Minister what challenges he sees with regards to those sites located further afield? So, for example, my sense is that the sites in Western Europe and the UK, the Falklands, are easily maintained and will be so for the future. But are there particular difficulties, perhaps, that may lie ahead for those sites that are located in Africa, across the Far East, and in further aflung places?
Firstly, my honourable friend raises one of the key challenges of maintaining sites, sometimes in places that have been quite hostile. I think one of the strengths of how the modern-day War Graves Commission does its job is by using local staff, by engaging locally, and indeed by being supported by both the department and the defence diplomatic network to make sure that we work with host governments as well. I'm in a sense more optimistic because I think this report will help open further the door for commemorating and finding and indeed maintaining some of those sites, because, you know, if we come along and say to the host countries, you know, hands up, this is what we could have done better, this is what we didn't do right, we have a far greater chance of being collectively able to commemorate those people and making sure that we educate both their populations and our populations here about the contribution that was made.